Good morning, church. Good morning, church. It's great to see you this morning. If you're able, let's rise to our feet this morning as we come again together as a congregation into the presence of God. This week, what I've been speaking to our team about is just lifting up the name of Jesus and the power that we have in that name. And this morning, I want to encourage each and every one of you to lift up that name with us. There's an old song that tells us how when the praises of God abound, His glory will surround us. And even as we enter into this healing and miracle service this morning, I want you to be, encourage you to be fixated on the name of Jesus, on keeping Him center of it all, on expecting to see His glory, on expecting to see his strength, on expecting to see Him move in power this morning, because He is more than able. So let's come together in prayer as we do that. Father, we thank You this morning. We thank You that You are good and You do good. We thank You that this morning Your mercies are new towards us. We thank You that You are faithful. And You can never show Yourself faithless, because that would be denying Yourself. We thank You, Father, Lord God, because we believe that by Your Spirit, You are helping us to stir up those wells of hope again, Father, Lord God, to expect great and wonderful things from a God who is great and wonderful. Father, we exalt You this morning. We lift You high. We worship You for who You are. We exalt You this morning, Lord. We lift Your name higher, and our eyes are fixed on You. hope is in you. Our hearts are wide open to you this morning. Our eyes are fixed on you. Our strength is found only in you. You are the source of our joy. You are everything to us. Everything we need is in you, Lord. We exalt you this morning. We lift you high. We glorify you. We choose to lay down every other thing, Father, Lord God, and let you be the only thing that remains. Thank you, Father, for your love towards us. Thank you, Father, for your mercies that are new. Never before. We want to experience you like never before. We want to draw closer to you, that you would draw nearer to us. We believe and we receive these things in the precious, wonderful name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
So let's praise our God this morning.
You here.
On the praises of your people. You are worthy. You are a great God and greatly to be praised. Father, we honor you. There is no God like our God. He is stronger than any other. He is greater than any other. He is almighty God in every way. He is above and beyond all understanding. We give you thanks.
Thank you. God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand?
Yeah. Peter and John were going together to the temple at the hour of prayer, the ninth hour, and a certain man, lame from his mother's womb, was carried, whom they had laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms from those who entered the temple. So this man was lame from birth. But seeing Peter and John, the disciples of Jesus, about to go into the temple asking for alms, asking for gifts of money, and fixing his eyes on him, the lame man, with John, Peter said, "Look at us." So he gave them his attention, expecting to receive something from them. Then Peter said, "Silver and gold I do not have, but what I do have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." Hallelujah. Glory to God. And what happened then? He took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and his ankle bone received strength. So he, leaping up, stood and walked and entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God, and they knew that he was the lame man who had been lame from birth. Now, what was it that changed this man's condition forever? He came into connection. He came into connection with the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And today, as we worship Jesus, let us know that as we come to him, the Prince of Life, our Redeemer, our Savior, our Deliverer, our Lover, our lifter of our head, as we come into connection, as we come and worship him, hallelujah, there is no other name that is higher than the name of Jesus. So if you have any condition, any sickness, any disease, anything of lack in your life, if it has a name, there is a name that is higher than that condition, and it is the name of Jesus Christ, and you can be delivered. Hallelujah. It goes on to say that when people questioning what happened to this man, and I'll drop down to verse 16 in Acts 3, and it says, his name, through faith in his name, whose name? Jesus. Shall we declare his name? Jesus. Faith in this name, faith in the name of Jesus, has made this man strong, whom you see and know. Yes, the faith which comes through him has given him this perfect soundness in the presence of you all. As we today have faith in this name, faith in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you will be made strong and you will receive soundness. If there's any lack in your life, lift up your hands to the King right now. Let us all lift our hands and let's draw near to Jesus. Let's draw near to the name that is higher than any other name. Let's draw near to the King Jesus and call upon him. Have faith in his name, hallelujah, that you can go free, you can be made whole, you can be restored, you can be made strong, you can have soundness, your situations and circumstances can change in the name of Jesus. Let's shout Jesus. Come on, people of God, let's call upon his name. Jesus, hallelujah, glory to God, give him a shout of praise, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, church, let us continue to appreciate him. Hallelujah, this morning. Let us appreciate him. It is by his grace, by his grace, by his grace. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Lord, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. In the name of Jesus. In the Bible, in the book of Job, chapter 12, from verse 7. But now ask the beast, and they will teach you. The birds of the air, and they will tell you. Or speak of the to the earth, and it will teach you. And the fish of the sea will explain to you. Who among all these does not know that the hand of the Lord has done this? In whose hand is life of every living thing? Hallelujah. Even the earth, the fish, everything upon this earth know that God is the source of everything. When you look at the fish, when they are in the aquarium, see how they swim, how they open up their fins. They are all giving glory to God. Hallelujah. So this morning, it is you and I alone who can manifest the glory of God. This is our year of grace and glory. Our year that we need to manifest his glory. So this morning, if you are here, as we heard, our eyes must be fixed on the author and the finisher of our faith. Take your eyes off your problems, your eyes off your challenges, and fix your eyes on Jesus. He is the only one who can do whatever you cannot do in your life. Hallelujah. The Bible says we should hold fast to the confession of our faith. What you believe is what you become. And what you want to become is what you declare over your life. Hallelujah. So this morning, I want us by faith to declare, say this after me. In the name of Jesus. I declare, I am strong, I am healed, I am bold, I am rich, I am the righteousness of God in Christ. I am honored, I am blessed, I am favored, I am an overcomer. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, no weapon form or fashion against me and my family shall prosper, because this is my year to overcome the challenges of life in Christ Jesus. This morning, as we continue with our worship, let us fix our eyes on the altar and the finisher of our faith. He is our source in everything that we do. Remember that even the fish and the earth and the beast, they all know that Christ or Jesus or God is their source, as we continue to worship and to appreciate the faithfulness of God in our life.
No other God can be called a father. No other God can be called a friend. No other God can be called redeemer. No other God's coming back again.
No other God,
no other God can be called a father. No other God can be called a friend. No other God can be called redeemer. No other God's coming back again.
We love your name.
We love your name.
came and brought us into the reign of grace. We love the fragrance of your holy name. You came and brought us into the reign of grace.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
To break every chain.
To break every chain. To break every chain. To break every chain.
To break every chain.
To break every chain. To break every chain. To break every chain.
There is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Let's give him a shout! to praise. Hallelujah. Let's lift up our shout. Let's lift up our countenance and give Jesus the best shout of praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we break every plan of the enemy. We destroy every spirit of fear, every lack, every oppression, every depression. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I come against every sickness, every disease, every mind-binding spirit, every addictive spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, and we break it. Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Kuraba si kere bahaya, muria shendere masi kere maha. Because it was by faith in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that this man who had been lame from birth stood up, was strengthened. And not only that, he was able to leap and praise God, and he was returned unto soundness. And they questioned him. The authorities questioned Peter, and they said, "What is it that's happened?" And he said, "It is by faith in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth." Hallelujah! Hallelujah! This is the gospel of grace. For it was not by this man's works, it was not by his good deeds. That day he hadn't fasted and he hadn't prayed, but he came into connection with a man who had the life of God flowing through him. Hallelujah! He came into connection to a disciple of Christ. Christ in him, the hope of glory. My dear brother and sister, you are that today. You have Christ in you, the hope of glory. And you can declare, as Peter declared, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So whatever lack there is in your life, I want you to do something really bold and really strong. I want you to take this word, this picture, this truth in the scripture and declare, I can do as Peter did. You might have something that's lame in your life. You might have something that's not working right. You might have your finances in debt. You might have something in your relationship, in your marriage. There's an area that's lame. I want you to know that the same spirit that flowed through Peter is in us now. The same spirit that rose Jesus Christ from the dead is in us now. All glory. Is there anything dead in your life? Then you take your mouth, your weapon of warfare. You take your tongue, your weapon of warfare, and you confess life. You speak life. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. You see, the enemy comes after our confession. He comes after our mouth. He wants us to speak death. He wants us to speak negativity. He wants us to speak lack. He wants because you're not going to just speak an empty word. You're going to speak a word of power. You're going to speak a word of life. You're not going to just trip it out of your mouth. You're going to speak it with force, because there's a life force coming behind that word, because God says, my word will not return to me void, but it will accomplish that which it was sent for. In other words, when you and I put God's word on our mouth, put it in our tongue, roll it around in our heart, meditate on it, cook it up, store it up, get it in our spirit, and come to a point and say, I will be made whole. Sickness, go now. Lack, go now. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You gonna get ready? Do you know what you're coming against? What's your mountain? What's your mountain you're gonna speak against today? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Don't leave it there another day. Okay, together. We're going to say this and then we're going to go into singing that song once more. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. By faith in his name, I declare every mountain in my life be removed. And you speak to your mountain, whatever it is right now. Speak to lack, speak to disease, speak to sickness, speak to fear, speak to depression, speak to pain, speak to brokenness, speak to it, command it to go in the name of Jesus. You are made whole. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, I declare whatever you have commanded, whatever you have spoken, may it come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. As we sing this song, we're not just singing, we're declaring war against any satanic agenda assigned against our lives, assigned against this church. We're going to pick up our weapon of warfare, and even as we're singing this song, something might come to mind that you say, enough is enough over that. And you might say once more, I speak to that mountain and I command it to go. You be led by the Spirit. But this is not a song we are singing. This is a warfare song. And we're entering into our promised land and we're taking authority in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's church. Let's stand to our feet if we can. And let's declare this song from our spirit. Jesus' name.
There is power,
there is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power,
there is power in the name of Jesus.
Wonder-working power,
there is power in the name of Jesus.
To break every chain,
to break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain.
There is power,
there is power.
To break every chain.
Jesus. And all God's people said, amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah. Well, welcome to Destiny Christian Center, London. It's great to see you here. Hallelujah. Why don't you turn to your neighbor and just bless them and welcome them. Gentlemen, good morning. May the Lord truly bless you. Welcome, everybody, this morning in Jesus' name. Do we have any first-time guests, any first-time visitors with us this morning? Would you be so kind as to lift your hands so we can acknowledge who you are at the back? Praise God. Church, do what we do best. Let's welcome them. Woo! Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We bless God. Hallelujah. Bible study begins again this Wednesday at 7:30. It's our equip service. Amen? Wednesday, 7:30. We'd love to see you. Come along and just experience afresh again what God is doing and how you can be equipped to go and do the work of God. Amen? Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Inspire, ladies. Woo! Inspire, Saturday the 7th of May. Saturday the 7th of May with Pastor Ilke Pei and our very own woman of God in the house, Pastor Ruth Anekwe. Hallelujah. It's going to be an anointed time. It really is. To experience again, ladies, the love of God afresh. Amen. Don't miss out. It's going to be an amazing time. It really will. It's free to book. Yeah. So come and register. You can register today. Get your tickets. Amen. And the menu is on the back table. So you can have a look and see what you're getting. Amen. Amen. Praise God. So come along. Be refreshed. Be revived. And be inspired in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Today is the 17th, amen? So it's our healing service. It's our healing service. Praise the Lord, amen. God is here. The Spirit of God is here to heal, to set free, and to deliver. Amen? So this morning we're going to experience a revelation, a new revelation of the power of God for each and every one of us to experience, amen? Because it will encourage us, it will build our faith, and we can bring our friends and all our families to come and experience the things that we're experiencing. Amen? In Jesus' name, praise God.
We've got some new ministries here at Destiny Christian Center, and we just want to make you aware of those. We have Inspire for Business for all women and entrepreneurs, businesswomen, or those who are dreaming of setting up business, then this is the Connect group for you. We are meeting this Wednesday, the 20th, 7 p.m. through to 8:30 p.m., and we're going to be meeting in the House of Fraser, Tea Rooms. So if you would like to be a part of that, then you can just come along at 7 o'clock. If you want more information, please go to the registration desk. If you give us your mobile, we'll connect you to the WhatsApp group and we'll let you know continually what's happening with that in ministry. But that's going to be a powerful time to connect with like-minded women and base our businesses on the foundation of God's truth. Spur one another on and be one another's biggest cheerleaders. Amen. You're going higher. Amen. So that's Inspire for Business. Inspire for Destiny is for all single ladies, and it's a social time of fun, friendship, and fellowship. And again, if you want to connect to women in the church in that way, then go to the registration desk leave your mobile number and your email, and we'll keep you connected as and when the next meetings are happening. Time for two is our couples group, and that's a connect group for our married couples. Whether you're newlywed or have been in married bliss for many years, that group is for you. It's a time for couples to come together, sharpen one another, encourage one another, share wisdom, and just have some fun time. Maybe get a babysitter, go out, have dinner together, fellowship in different ways. So that's time for two. And Richard and Harriet, if you'd like to just give us a wave, are organising that. So if you'd like to be involved, then go and speak to them. Also, you can put your details on the information desk. Praise God. We have a new Connect group that will be starting in Acton, and we'll let you know the exact time of that. But just to let you know up front, there's going to be a Connect group in the area. So if you live in and around the area, then that's going to be a great place where you can go and fellowship, pray, connect, and pray for the area together. Amen. We have an evangelism team, and we're meeting every second Saturday at 2 p.m. to go out in this local area, handing out information about the church, meeting people. I mean, it's just great. Nearly every week, we're seeing some people who have come in through us handing invites out to people. And there's even a dear lady here. I won't name you, but I handed a leaflet to you, and she's here second time. So it's just great to see you here with us. And it's really encouraging because, you know, there are people who are ready to hear God's good news. And maybe they haven't got a church family. Maybe they're looking for a church. But God will lead you to people. So you're equipped to do that. You're ministers of reconciliation. So come along and be a part of that team on a Saturday, 2 p.m. Again.
take a moment to fill out. Leave us some details so we can pray with you. Also, let us know how you found your time with us here at Destiny. That'll be a blessing so that we can be better positioned to serve you better. Amen. The book of James chapter 1, if you have a Bible this morning, James chapter 1. Also, just to make you aware, our evangelism team is going out this morning after the service to do some ministry. So if you have some time, they would love for you to join them. For more details, please see either Ebenezer or Tina Nati. They're going to meet straight up in the foyer after service. Go out and just allow that anointing to flow through them. Amen. Amen. Praise God. James chapter 1, please, if you have a Bible this morning. We're going to get straight into the Word of God. Now, this morning, I'm going to have to apologize up front for you that I'm not going to be able to stay around and mingle and mix and chat like I normally do after service just to say hello and to get to know you. This morning is my mother's 70th birthday. Praise God. Amen. Thank you so much. 70 years and she still looks so good. Amen. So as a whole family, we're getting together this morning to go and celebrate her. So straight after service, I'm going to just grab our boys and I'm going to dash straight over there. And so please do apologize up front. Don't feel pastors being mean or that I didn't want to say hello to you this morning. Every morning we're here celebrating and saying hello to you after church. Isn't that right? So you can maybe just help us out this one Sunday by just being understanding. Amen. Thank you so much. Father, we thank you for this opportunity to gather around your word. Thank you today that this word is settled in heaven. Thank you that the entrance of your word brings light. And today that entrance brings light into every heart and life. I thank you for the grace, the unction, the anointing and ability to speak this word. Thank you also for your people today that are anointed to hear, understand, perceive, and do what your word is saying. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. Spirit of the living God, I pray that you will do what you do best. Touch, heal, and restore. And whatever is wrong, thank you by faith today that you will set right. We give you thanks. We give you praise in advance in Jesus' mighty name. Let the people say amen this morning. Amen. Amen. The book of James chapter 1, please. If you have a Bible with me this morning, James chapter 1. Let's get straight into it this morning, James chapter 1, verse 17, please. Praise God. If you have it, please say amen for me. Amen. Amen. I want us all to read this together, if you can. James chapter 1 and verse 17. James chapter 1, verse 17. Ready? Let's read. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above. Everybody's not reading. Let's all try again. Ready? Let's read. Every good, that's it, and every perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow of turning. James says in chapter 1 now that every good and every perfect gift comes from above. Every good and every perfect gift. How many of you know this morning, God only gives you and wants to give you good gifts in your life? Jesus said, if ye being evil, know how to give good things to your children, your natural children here on earth. And he doesn't say you're evil in the sense that, you know, you murdered anybody or anything like that. He said, no, you in your best form compared to God, the comparison, he says, is like good and evil. So you on your best day, when those children haven't got on your last nerve, when they haven't turned the house upside down, when you've done your best to pray and say, Jesus, help me this morning, I'm going to be a good parent, but the minute you step out of bed and the first 5 minutes, you're already ready to hang them from the chandeliers. On your best day, he says, you, compared to God, it's like good and even. And he said, if you, being like that, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more your heavenly Father. So the scripture says today now, every good gift comes from above. And notice with me, every gift that God gives is also perfect. So he says, every good now and perfect gift comes from God. So this morning, God I declare, wants to bless your life with good and perfect gifts. Can you say amen this morning? God wants to bless your life with good and perfect gifts. He said, how many of you here, when your son asks for bread, is going to give him a stone or a scorpion? How many of you here, when your son asks for something good, you're going to swap it and give him something evil? How much more now, your Heavenly Father today, that when you come to him, his heart for you and his desire for you is to bless your life, to do something and to give something that is good and that is perfect in your life. Can you say amen today? That every time we gather, that God's heart is to do and to give something good. It comes from above. It comes from above. So God is good and God gives good. Devil is bad and the devil gives bad. Let's not confuse the two, because we got some crazy Christians in the body of Christ who somehow feel that God is the one doing some evil things in their life in order such that they can somehow become closer to him. We've got some mixed up schizophrenic Christians in the body of Christ who have an understanding that God is the one that's going to cause your car to crash such that you can turn to him. God is the one that's going to give you sickness to prove that he's God. Come on, let's get it straight this morning. Amen. God is good. God is good. God is good. Amen. I like that. All the time. He is good. So every good gift comes from God. Who is good? Comes from above. Every bad gift comes from the devil. Are you with me here today? Every good gift comes from above. Comes from the Father of lights. She's dressing me while I preach. In whom there is no variableness or shadow of turning. Can you say amen? Amen. Next she's going to go like that, get a spit and start cleaning you. You remember how your mom used to clean you when you were little? Praise God. Acts chapter 10, please. Let's have a look at that. Every good, he says, gift comes from above, comes from the Father of lights, in whom there is no variableness. One translation says that there is no shadow of turning with him. In other words, it means that today he's not going to be a good God, a loving God, a gracious God, and then tomorrow, all of a sudden, he's going to be a God that wants to nail you into the ground. It means that in him there is no variableness, no changing. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Can you say amen this morning? He never changes. He's the same. He's constant. He doesn't come one day and do you good, and the next day he decides he's going to nail you to the ground. In whom there is no change or variableness or shadow of turning. Are you in Acts chapter 10, please? Look at verse 38 with me. Very familiar scripture. You've seen it before. Acts chapter 10 and verse 38. What does it say? How God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus, the name that is above every name. The name that is above every situation. The name that is higher than anything you face here today. Whatever you face, whatever sickness, whatever disease, whatever challenge, it's got a name. And God has given him the name that is above every name. How God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit. Please underline that today. He anointed him with the Holy Spirit. Anointed him with the Holy Spirit. And with power. And now what happened? He went about doing good. He went about doing good. James 1 says every good and perfect gift comes from above. Perfect means complete. It means lacking nothing. It means sound. It means 100%. So God's not going to do a half job. God's not going to do a bobber job. You understand? God's not just going to do a cowboy builder job. No, he does a complete work. Amen, amen, amen. He does a complete work. Bible says those that he saved, he is able to save to the uttermost. It's not a half save, you understand? It's not a quarter save, not a 1 foot in the kingdom, 1 foot down, no. You are completely, 100% saved to the uttermost, which means if I were to peradventure meet him today and stand before his throne, I know it will be well between me and my God. Amen. He went about doing good. every good gift from him. Jesus was anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, went about doing good. What kind of good did he do? Let's look at the next verse. What does it say? The next line? Healing. All. Let's take it step by step. He went about doing good. What was the good that he did? Healing. No, let's get to the all in a minute. He went about doing good. The good that he did was what?
Healing.
So healing is good. And every good gift comes from a father. Comes from above, the Father of lights, in whom there is no variableness, no shadow of turning. There's no favoritism amongst him. He's not going to come and heal Janet and then look at you and say, no, forget that. He's not going to heal Funmi, or he's not going to bless one individual. When it comes to you, he says, I don't like your shoes this morning. I don't like your hairstyle. I know what you did last night. I saw you and your husband rowing. Come on now, somebody. And Jesus was anointed with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good. And the first category of good, the Bible says, he was anointed to do was what?
Healing.
Was what?
Healing.
It was what?
Healing.
Amen, amen. So we can draw the inference that it is good from God when the healing showed. Oh, glory to God. Amen. Healing half of them who were oppressed. Healing three-quarters of them who were oppressed. Healing the tall ones, the short ones, the broad ones, the good-looking ones, the ones that were more fearfully than wonderfully made. Healing, come on now, talk to me. How many? All who were oppressed by the devil. For God was with him. He was anointed. So James says every good comes from God. Jesus Christ was anointed with the Holy Spirit and power. And when he was anointed, he started doing good. The anointing brought good. Are you with me here today? Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. So as we gather today, understand now, God is not, there's no variableness with him. There's no shadow of turning. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Are you with me today? Matthew chapter 7, let's look at a few scriptures and then we'll wait on the name of the Lord today. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Did I hear my child in that, Lord? It wasn't mine, it was yours, man. Trust me. Amen. Matthew chapter 7, look at verse 7. What does it say? Matthew 7 and 7. Ask, and it will be given you. Seek, he said, and you will find. Knock, he said, and the door shall be opened. Now, in the literal tense of this scripture, the literal present tense of this scripture says, ask and keep on asking. It says, seek and keep on seeking. Knock and keep on knocking. Tell someone, keep on knocking. Nudge your neighbor on the other side. Say, keep on knocking. Keep on ask. Not just one time. He said, ask and keep on asking. Ask and keep on asking. If my children want something, they ask me once. I say no. They keep on asking. No is not the end of the matter for them. No is just the beginning of the discussion. It's just the beginning. And they keep asking. Anybody know what I'm talking about? They keep asking and asking and asking and asking until they literally wear you down. Now, you don't have to ask and ask to wear God down. His heart is already towards you. But what I'm saying is ask in faith. Keep on asking, because every good comes from him. Jesus was anointed with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good. And the category of good that he did was healing all that were oppressed by the devil, was destroying the works of the enemy, was setting the captives free, was proclaiming liberty to those that were oppressed. Do you understand what I'm saying? So today, for you as well, he's no different. In him, there is no shadow of turning. Psalm 103, please. Psalm 103. Psalm 103. I'm going to say something that might sting somebody here this morning, but I'm going to hit you with it. If God says that he is no respecter of person, and you sit there and think, well, listen, vicar, you don't understand my situation, and everything I'm saying is hitting a brick wall and bouncing because you think I don't understand what you're going through, you're making God a liar. Are you listening to me? Because if you're thinking God is not understanding what I'm facing here and somehow I don't believe he can do it, then either God is true, let every man be a liar. So either God is true and your circumstances are false, or you're saying God is a liar. In other words, he can't do it and he won't do it. Amen. Amen. Psalm 103. Come on, let's read very quickly. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of his benefits, who forgives all your iniquities. Keep your hand where, right where we are. Just flip back with me, Psalm 68. We're going to go back to Psalm 103, but I want you to see Psalm 68, please. When you get there, look with me, verse 19. What does the Bible say? Blessed be the Lord who daily loads us, who daily loads us with benefits. Some modern translations may say blessings, but benefits, the God even of our salvation. So the Psalm 68 says God loads us with benefits. Psalm 103 says, don't forget now, what are these benefits? Tell your neighbor, don't forget now. Don't forget. Don't. Begins to list them. He forgives all your sins, all our iniquities. Look at the second benefit. What is it? He heals all our diseases. He heals all our diseases. So your God is a God from which every good and perfect gift comes from above. Perfect, complete, entire, lacking nothing, not half a job. Not a quarter a job. When Jesus was anointed, he went about doing good, healing all those who were oppressed by the devil. And God was with him. The psalmist says he daily, every day, loads you with benefits. Every day. Lamentation says his mercies are new every morning. The psalmist says his benefits are daily towards you. Are you with me today? Oh, glory to God. There's some folk who, when they're on benefits, natural benefits, every week without fail, you will collect. Amen. Every week without fail, you collect. Why? Because they're my benefits. If they tamper with their benefits, there's a fight. Amen, amen. Now, please follow me, please follow me. I'm saying those benefits you understand and we receive them gratefully because you say they're yours, you're entitled to him. The psalmist says God daily loads you with benefits. Daily brings you benefits and blessings. We didn't even read all of them. He forgives our sins, heals our iniquities, crowns you with loving kindness, renews your youth like the eagles. But here you are, heals every disease, heals all of our diseases. And the Bible says they are benefits for you. Amen, amen.
Amen.
John chapter 7, let's close here. John chapter 7. Thank you, Lord. Verse 37, look what Jesus says. It says, on the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, if anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. Glory. Then he said in verse 36, look at this now, 38, sorry. He who believes in me, thank you, Rosetta. Anybody else this morning? Thank you, Alice. Go ahead. He that believes in me now, he that believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart, some Bible says his belly, out of his innermost being shall flow rivers of living water. Whoever believes in him, he says, out of his innermost being, out of his heart shall flow rivers of living water. And this he spoke concerning the Spirit whom those believing in him would receive. For the Holy Spirit was not yet given because Jesus was not yet glorified. So he predicted, he prophesied, and he said, whoever is going to believe in me, out of their innermost being is going to flow rivers. And he spoke that of the Spirit that was yet to be given because he had not been glorified. Prophesying, speaking of a day would come, a Pentecost would come, when the Spirit shall be poured out upon all flesh, and whoever believes in him, glory to God, out of him, the Holy Spirit, oh glory, out of him, the Spirit without measure, out of him, the Spirit shall come, out of him, when you get born again, the Spirit comes and lives on the inside of you. Amen, amen.
Amen.
So does anybody believe in him today?
Yes.
Anybody believe in him today?
Yes.
You believe in him today now. So you qualify now for what he's saying. That out of that individual, there shall flow, and he spoke it of the Spirit that was to come. Final scripture, Romans chapter 8. And in verse 11, look at it. It says, but if now, the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you. Does it dwell in anybody today?
Yes.
If the Spirit, he says, that raised Jesus from the dead dwells and lives in you, he that raised Christ from the dead will also give life, will also quicken, will also energize, will also make alive, will also regenerate, will also heal, will also bring life where your mortal body was dead. Amen and amen and amen. Amen and amen. Now, how's he going to do it? Finish the verse. Through his Spirit that dwells in you. So on the last day of the feast, he said, whoever believes in me, out of him shall flow rivers. And he spoke of the Spirit that was yet to come now. And when you got born again, Jesus came to live on the inside of you. The Spirit of God came to dwell on the inside of you. And now Romans says, now because Jesus spoke about an event that was to come, but now we are living in that which has happened. He said, if that Spirit, if you be in Christ, if that Spirit that raised him from the dead will dwell in you, that Spirit shall also make alive, shall also give life, shall also heal, shall also produce every good and perfect gift. Through that same Spirit that dwells in you today. Amen and amen. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Listen, when you come before God, the Bible says because you believe in him, there's already a life-giving force that's on the inside of you. The Spirit that raised him from the dead is already there. The Spirit that quickened and raised him, he said, is already in you because whoever believes in him, out of him shall flow, out of him shall flow. Out of him shall flow rivers, speaking of the Spirit. Proverbs says, guard your heart, for out of it shall flow the issues of life. It speaks about force. It speaks about a power. Are you listening to me today? So as you come before God, you're not begging him. Every good gift is from him. As you come before God, you're not hoping and wishing, because in him there is no variableness or shadow of turning. He daily desires to bless us with benefits. And now you understand the Spirit that raised him from the dead. He said, he's living on the inside of me. And he said, that thing shall also give life. That thing shall also quicken. That thing shall also make alive your mortal bodies.
Yes.
Hallelujah and amen.
It's not because you and I are perfect. It's because of faith in his name.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's because of faith in his name. Faith in that name. The name that is above every name. The name, Peter said, by which this man stands healed before you this day. When he addressed the leaders in Jerusalem. The name, Jesus said, which he has given him, that has exalted him above every name. Oh, glory to God. That name is still alive today.
Amen.
That name is still powerful today.
Hallelujah.
That name still heals today.
Amen.
That name still delivers today.
Yes.
That name still makes whole today.
Amen.
That name is able to go where even your physical legs can't go. Because some of you think, well, Pastor, if I could get there, I could just change the situation. No, that name can go there for you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Lord,
that name
Lord,
can open a door for you
Lord,
when you are not even in the room. You understand what I'm saying? That name can cause your name to be remembered
Amen.
When your name was long forgotten 20 years ago. That name can call somebody, wake them up in the midnight hour, give them a picture with your face on it, and say, I have to find this individual. When you did not deserve, am I talking to anybody in the house? That name can teach you what you didn't learn at school. That name can lift you above your station right now. That name can cause you and give you a name when everybody else is despising your name because you don't think I have a worthy name. He said, no, I will give you my name. So right now you have his name. And your name becomes his name, and his name becomes your name. And when they call his name, glory to God, you got every right to receive your benefits. Are you ready to receive your benefits this morning? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That name can restore your soul. Oh, karamasekerebota. That name can restore your soul. When men spoke against you and circumstances beat you down and situations wore you down, that name can lift you up. That name can cause you to walk with your head held high once again. That name can give you an inheritance and a future where right now there doesn't seem any future for you. That name can rearrange that which was written in the past and make it such that your story today doesn't have to reflect what was in your past. What I'm talking about, maybe in your past, it was littered with mistakes, littered with wrong turns, littered with crazy stuff. But with that name now, it can rewrite that thing in order by writing you a new story today, such that when they call you, you think I'm kidding? Read Isaiah chapter 62. He said, I will give you a name, glory to God, a name that no other has given unto you. I'm not talking crazy stuff here. Do you understand? Amen, amen.
Amen.
That name can make you a somebody. When the world looks at you and thinks you're a nobody. When the world looks at you and looks down at you and thinks they don't even have to give you the time of day. That name is a name that will lift you up from the miry clay. Will set your feet on solid ground. That name is a name that will restore. That will restore the years that the locusts have eaten. I believe there's anointing to restore some years that the locusts have eaten this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Joel chapter 2, he says, I will restore unto you the years that the locusts have eaten. And then in chapter 1, he speaks about what happens when the cankerworm has come and the chewing locust has come, sorry, and the swarming locust has come. And the fine locust has come. But what does it matter what kind of name it is, Pastor? A locust by any name is still a locust. It still has the same effect. But he is the God that can restore every year. That the year. Come on, say every year, somebody. Come on, say every year. Come on, shout every year. That the locusts have eaten. Amen, amen. Hallelujah. That name will make you look younger than you are.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Are you kidding me? Just look at some folk that don't live without his name.
You look at them, they're 36. They look like they should be 65. But that name will give you youth. Renew it like the eagle. Keep you looking fresh, man. You understand? I know black doesn't crack, but this name will do something crazy for you. Make it even better for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody help me lift up that name. Just bless that name this morning. Come on, just bless that name this morning. Oh, come on, help me celebrate that name. Yeah, come on, lift up that name, that name, that name. Oh, honor that name this morning. Extol that name this morning. Bless and magnify that name this morning. Oh, oh, glory, glory, glory to that name. There's some names that give you access here on earth. There's some names that open doors in certain establishments. But a name that opens a door with a bank might not open a door at a university. But this name will give you access. This name is a name that is recognized here on earth, under the earth, and is recognized in heaven. Come on, somebody help me bless that name today. Oh, bless that name. Bless that name. Bless that name. You need to understand there's life in that name. You need to understand there's hope in that name. There's a future in that name. There's some things that answer, oh glory, to money. Some things answer to influence. Something answer to prestige. But all things answer to that name. Your healing is in that name. Your restoration is in that name. Your liberty is in that name. Your freedom is in that name. Your sound mind is in that name. Your peace is in that name. Your hope is in that name. Everything you need is in that name. Tell you folks, there's sometimes when I've prayed in English and it's as if my English doesn't open the door. My tongues maybe doesn't open, but when I've just spoken the name of Jesus to that thing, there's some things you don't have to pray in English language. Just speak the name of Jesus at it. Say Jesus at that thing. Jesus at that thing. Jesus at that thing. You might seem crazy, but listen, that name is powerful. Come on, call on that name, Jesus. There's strength in that name today. Favor in that name today. There's help in that name today. Wisdom in that name today. Healing in that name today. Come on, the Bible promises, whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord. Whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord. Whosoever calls upon that name. As soon as you call that name, it catches his attention. When the crowds were pressing in and he was on his way to Jericho, there was one man who was by the road, in amongst all the multitude, and he called out and said, Jesus, Son of David. He called out and said, Jesus, Son of David. That one man in all the crowd called out, Jesus, Son of David. And Jesus heard him. Ask and keep on asking. And keep on seeking. Knock and keep on knocking. Bob says he was in a synagogue one day and he was preaching to the church, and one woman that had an issue of blood, she said to herself, Jesus saw her, called her, and said, woman, thou art loose from this infirmity. If he saw her, he will see you today. Jesus. inheritance and a future where right now there doesn't seem any future for you. That name can rearrange laid ground. That name is a name that will restore. Amen. Are you kidding me? Just look at some folk that don't live without his name. You look at that name. Yeah, come on, lift up that name, that name, that name. After the service to do some ministry, so praise God. James chapter. Chapter 1, please, if you have a Bible this morning. Hallelujah. That name can open a door for you when you are not even in the room. You understand what I'm saying? That name can cause your name. His name. Hallelujah. It's because of faith in his name. Faith in that name. The name that is above every name. The name, Peter said, by which this man stands healed in your name. Because you don't think I have a world turns littered with crazy stuff. But with that name now, and restore every year. That the year. Come on, say every year. Oh, honor that name this morning. Extol. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody help me lift up that name. Just bless that name this morning. Come on, just bless that name this morning. Oh, come on, help me celebrate that name. Yeah, come on, lift up that name, that name, that name. Oh, honor that name this morning. Extol that name this morning. Bless and magnify that name this morning. Oh, oh, glory. Oh, come on, help me.
and causes you to win, causes you to gain victory in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Shira masandara mahaya. Rimandara masikere mashisende. Kiandara masikele maha. Thank you, Lord. The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Strong and mighty. Mighty in battle. The Lord strong and mighty. Mighty in battle.
Yes, Lord.
The Lord strong and mighty. Mighty in battle. Kishere mahanda. By faith, we plead the blood of Jesus against every satanic agenda assigned over your life.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name. Every spirit of addiction, every spirit of destruction, every spirit of limitation, every disease, every bondage, every strong man that's kept you down, in the name of Jesus Christ, we come against it.
Yes.
And we tear down the strongholds of the enemy.
Yeah.
We tear them down in Jesus' name. We tear down every bondage in Jesus' name.
Yes,
every addictive cycle, every spirit of anger, every destructive force in the name of Jesus, every mind-binding spirit, every spirit of control, we tear you down. In Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. There's some people who have been harassed. I can't find another word, but harassed by the enemy. Harassed by the enemy. Day in, day out. Harassed. Whatever it is. And I tell you today, that harassment will stop.
Come on, in
Jesus' name.
Lift up your hands this morning.
In Jesus' name.
Lift up those hands.
In Jesus' name. If you're feeling harassed right now,
lift up your name, just declare it, and we'll set free. Yeah, go on.
If you're feeling harassed right now, you come now and come and receive your breakthrough. You come now that you're hungry for your breakthrough. You come now that you're hungry to be free. You will not contain it. You will not have it. One more day, you have to have that fire in you that says, I want to be free from this harassment. I'm going to be free. This day forward, I'm going to be free. I will not live with it. I will not have it. In Jesus' name. And so you coming from your seat to the front is a sign, is an indication to your soul. You are serious about this. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Come on, congregation. Let's continue to worship. Let's continue to worship. Let's continue to praise God. Lift up the name of Jesus. Lift up the name of Jesus. There's going to be breakthroughs in this house. Smart it. Oh, Jesus. Jesus.
Yes,
Jesus. Call upon his name. Call upon his name. Say, Jesus. 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 Jesus, Jesus, Shikaramaya Ramai, call upon his name,
Jesus,
call upon his name.
I call you Jesus, oh, I call you Jesus, oh, I call you Jesus.
Above, name above. Master, Savior, Lover, Giver, name above all names.
You're the ruler,
Lord, Redeemer, risen, conqueror, Jesus, Jesus, name above all names. Jesus, Jesus, name above all.
name is greater than
Jesus.
Nobody stronger than
Jesus.
Nobody bigger than
Jesus.
No name is higher than
Jesus.
There is no healer like
Jesus.
No deliverer like
Jesus.
Your name is Jesus.
Your name is Jesus. Risen from the dead.
Beautiful one, we love you. fragrance of your holy name. You came and brought us into the reign of grace.
Above every name. And even today, if there's any name that is prevailing in the lives of your people, let the name of Jesus right now dismantle it. Let the name of Jesus be established in their lives today. I thank you for healing. I thank you for wholeness. I thank you for restoration. I thank you for all that you have done today in the mighty name of Jesus. I sense in my spirit that God, the word of the Lord for someone here today, is that he is writing a new chapter in your life. It's beginning from today in the name of Jesus. I don't know who that is. I don't know what it, but I know. I know by I know my name. I know by unction of the Spirit of God. Maybe the impartation of this healing miracle today for you was today. My life, he is writing a new chapter. He's begun a new thing. He's beginning a new work in my life. He is writing a new story, a new chapter. In the mighty name of Jesus. You receive that by faith today. Come on, give the Lord a big hand clap this morning. Hallelujah. Somebody say Jesus. Come on, shout Jesus. One more time, shout Jesus. To continue to worship God as we honor him with our giving this morning. Our stewards should have found you and just supplied you with the ability to love God with our giving. If you need an envelope, lift up your hands. They're going to come and serve you very quickly this morning. And let's go ahead. Let's take a moment quickly to honor him and to love him today.